You have saved us by your passion and have given us us life by your resurrection. Now renew our image by your grace. Clothe our bodies with the power of the Spirit, so that we may shine in the robe of glory, and in its light see you, the true bridegroom. In your grace, make us and all the faithful departed worthy of your heavenly kingdom, that we may raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father and your Holy Spirit, forever.
Oh, God.
descend upon the reader and the listeners, and upon this parish and her children forever.
Brothers and sisters, you were dead through the trespasses and sin which you once lived, following the course of this world, following the ruler of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work among those who are disobedient. All of us once lived among them in the passions of our flesh, following the desires of flesh and senses, and we were, by nature, children of wrath, like everyone else. But God, who is rich in mercy, out of the great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead through our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace, we have been saved and raised up with him and seated us with him in the heavenly place in Christ Jesus, so that in the ages to come, he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in kindness towards us in Christ Jesus. For by grace, you have been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not the result of work, so that no one may boast. For we are what he has made us, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand to be our way of life.
Praise be to God always.
By which he would glorify God. After this, he said to him, This is the truth. Peace be with you.
Accomplish or to do what maybe God has called us to do.
or willing to do what we are asked to do. And so here is Peter, his day of reckoning. And it wasn't to humiliate him. It wasn't justifiably fire him. It was to reinforce him. You know, if Judas would have asked Jesus for forgiveness, he would have found it. He certainly would have been forgiven. But he picked the wrong group to ask for forgiveness. Not everybody out there is interested in whether or not we find Jesus Christ. In fact, the world is packed full of people who give you a million different reasons and justifications to do something else with any type of hurt that might come into your life. Any kind of questioning on the way of the Lord. To use those reasons as not to eat what the sheep are asked to eat. He said, tend my sheep, feed my sheep, take care of them. If you've ever had a farm, or relatives that had a farm, all the foods that the cows and the horses and the sheep want to eat the most is very often the foods that will kill them. And so, in a way, Peter is also saying and hearing in his hurt, you know what I feel. You know I love you. You know all of this. And Jesus could have said, well, why don't you act like it then? I mean, I could hear myself think that. And I remember growing up somebody saying it to me. But I think you get the point here. A whole lot is going on between the two of them. But equally so, an awful lot should go on between ourselves and Jesus. And sometimes it's the wrong thing to feed what people want to hear and then wind up being poisoned. Very often we do it to ourselves. That something very wonderful can be going on and we have wonderful memories of something in our life for a long time, and then we find out something else about a person that might be involved in it. And it crushes us. And it hurts us. And it disappoints us. But the grace of God asks us not to feed on that. But feed on the nurturing ability that Jesus has. Feed on the forgiveness that he shows. Feed on the mercy and the compassion that he shows. That his response to all things is to heal us and to give us strength, to encourage us. But definitely he does have to correct us. And he does that in this particular way. Trying to get to that hurt that we have and heal it. I think all of us, in some way or another, have had times where we really question God. And that is something that should be done at different times. Not to attack and to deny our faith. But very often that happens in order for us to deepen who we are. After all, isn't that what love is between people who love each other? Between spouses? If not before the marriage, certainly after the marriage, you're going to find out that the person you married isn't as perfect as you thought. Now, you yourself remain absolutely perfect, it was the other person. But somehow you have to reach that point where you know that you're loved. And you know that you love the other person, even in their imperfections. Now that doesn't mean we have permissions to continue to go as we are. But when we feel safe, and we feel secure, and we know the tenderness of his love, we're willing to let go of those things in our life that can harm ourselves and others, and eat the right food. This is the place to hear his message, to hear and come in contact with this food for the sheep. We call it the Holy Eucharist, the bread that came down from heaven, the bread that was pierced, but the bread that is living, the bread that can be misused, but is forgiving. As imperfect as we are, the words are said. Receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus for the forgiveness of sins and for eternal life.
Through him all things made, for our sin and for our sin.
from Adam to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, Saint Mary, Saint Joseph, and Saint Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom this sacrifice is offered or charming. Remember also those who share with us today in this offering.
Lord, Mercy on us, O mighty Father.
the pardon of faults, the honor of building and strengthening of your holy church, the protection of her children from sin, and may these mysteries allow us to stand with confidence before your awesome throne, that we may raise glory to you and to your only Son, and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Protect your shepherds of the true faith in security and peace all the days of their lives, especially Francis, the Pope of Rome, Bishop Peter, our Patriarch of Antioch, Gregory John, our Bishop, and all bishops, pious priests, pure deacons, and all who serve your holy altar. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, all those who call upon your holy name. Bless those who are near and bring back those who are far. Visit the sick and strengthen the weak. Release captives and assist the oppressed. Bring back those who have strayed that they may live in your fear, and reward those who have brought offerings to your holy church. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, our civil leaders and all the children of your holy church. Grant them security and peace, and keep domestic and foreign conflicts far from them, so that they may live in tranquility. Protect them by the sign of your living and victorious cross. Rescue the persecuted and the displaced of your flock, and be a refuge for strangers and a companion to travelers. Grant eternal reward to monks and to those who live solitary lives, and to hermits who live on the mountaintops and in the caves of the earth. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, upon this altar and upon your heavenly altar, the holy and ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the prophets, apostles, martyrs, confessors, evangelists, John the Baptist, the forerunner, Stephen, the archdeacon and first martyr, St. Joseph, St. Jude, St. Marin, St. Charbel, and all the saints. May we join in their ranks and share in their joyful feast. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the faithful teachers who have gone to their rest in the true faith, especially Peter, Paul, Mark, Clement, Ignatius, Dionysus, Julius, and all those who endured suffering and persecution for the strengthening of your holy church. Remember also those who serve your holy altar and forgive their sins, that they may reach your joyful dwellings. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, all those who have left this world and have gone to you, especially Charlie. Lead them to your joyful dwellings and blot out all their sins. Through our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, who is without sin, we hope to find mercy and forgiveness for our sins and for theirs.
Grant rest, O God, to the departed, and forgive the sins you have committed, with or without full knowledge.
Grant us pardon, O God, and forgive us and the departed, so that your blessed name may be glorified in us and in all things. With the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and that of your living Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Was, is now,
shall be forever.
Amen.
Ayah, Rabu, Rama, Ka, Wash, Ayah, Ayah, Wash.
By the grace of your only Son, the descent of your Holy Spirit, sanctify us now, that we may be renewed as your spiritual children, so that with your hearts and enlightened souls, we may call upon you, O glorious Father, and lover of all people, praying.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Deliver us, O Lord, from every temptation of soul and body, and crush our enemy, the evil one. Grant us your mercy through Christ Jesus our Lord, who are blessed and glorified with him and with your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads before the God of mercy, before his forgiving altar, and before the body and blood of our Savior, who gives life to those who partake of him, and receives the blessing from the Lord.
O Lord, look upon us, your inheritance, who bow before you, and guide our steps on your right path. Make us worthy to share in this sacrifice, and may it sanctify the souls and bodies of those who receive it. Through Christ Jesus our Lord, we glorify and honor you and your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most Holy Trinity, eternal and constant, shall be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility and ask him for mercy and compassion.
Holy gifts for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit, blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth. To him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by your holy body, and our souls purified by your forgiving blood. May our community be for forgiveness of our sins and for new life. O Lord our God, we do give you glory.
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ for us, sinners, and eternal life.
This is the week where we have the relics of St. Charbel, starting on Thursday. It's in the envelope that is being sent, or you can pick up in the boxes in the entrances of the church. That's also the bishop's appeal is also, and that's what's in the envelope, but also the schedule for the relics. Most importantly, the liturgy is on Thursday and Friday at 6 p.m. with the blessing with the relics. Also, Saturday is an informal dance for the parish. Also, that can be found information in the bulletin or on the poster on the book there. And hope to see you that somewhere along the line during those 2 days, you are there to at least spend some time in prayer. And if there's everything going perfectly in your life, you probably know somebody that it's not, come and pray for them. Oh God the Father, how can we who are unworthy thank you for your grace? For you have given us this divine gift, and have made us worthy to share in the body of love of your only begotten Son, who saved us. We glorify and honor you and your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, you are worshipped and you are holy. Bless and forgive the priests who are the stewards of your people and of your holy church. Forgive the servers of your divine mysteries and all the faithful who have shared in this sacrifice. Care for the orphans, help the widows, assist the poor and the distressed, satisfy the hungry, and protect all who call upon your holy name in every place. May your name be glorified with that of your Father and your Holy Spirit, who is good, life-giving, and consubstantial with you, now and forever.
Amen. Please stand.
Go in peace, my beloved brothers and sisters, with the nourishment and blessings you have received from the forgiving of the Lord. May the blessing of the Most Holy Trinity accompany you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the one God, to whom be glory forever.
Amen.
I leave you
in peace, O holy altar, and I hope to return to you in peace. May the offering I have received from you be for the forgiveness of my faults and the remission of my sins, that I may stand without shame or fear.